Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about digestive glands. When we say about glands, see, glands are basically cells, or they can be group of cells which are basically involved in secretion. So any single cell or group of cells that are secreting something, we call them glands. If we talk about type of glands, basically three type of glands are present: exocrine, endocrine and heterocrine. What is the basic difference between exocrine, endocrine and heterocrine? See, exocrine are those glands which are containing duct. Now, what do you mean by duct? Duct is simply a passage. Suppose this is a gland and this is the duct. This is the passage through which this gland is going to release its secretion. Such type of glands are known as exocrine gland. And as we are discussing in this topic digestive glands, so most of the digestive glands are exocrine in their nature. Endocrine are those glands which are not having these ducts. Ducts are absent, so these are endocrine glands. And heterocrine glands are having ducts, but they are functioning as both exocrine and endocrine gland. If I talk about the secretion, the exocrine gland, the secretion is basically containing enzymes. So most of the enzymes are secreted by exocrine glands. Endocrine glands, the secretion is contain hormones. And heterocrine gland, as it is functioning as both exocrine and endocrine, so these glands are going to release enzymes as well as hormones. So most of the digestive glands are exocrine in nature and some are heterocrine in nature, which are functioning as both exocrine and endocrine. So in a sequential manner, I am going to discuss each and every gland of our digestive system. First one is salivary gland. As the name is suggesting, the glands which are responsible for the secretion of saliva are known as salivary glands. So if we discuss in detail about the salivary glands, we are having three pairs of salivary glands. The first one is parotid gland. Among all the salivary glands, this is the largest gland and it is present near the ear. The ear is there and the opening is on the upper second molar, near the upper second molar, means it is opening near the upper jaw, near the second molar. And the duct of parotid glands is known as Stenson's duct. The second one is sublingual, the smallest salivary gland. And this is present below our tongue. And opening is also at the floor of our oral cavity, means at the base. It is going to open and the duct is known as duct of Ravinus. The third one is submandibular, or we sometimes say it as submaxillary. It is also present near the sublingual gland, but it is present at an angle of our lower jaw and its opening is near our incisors, lower incisors. And the duct is known as Wharton's duct. So if I represent all these three glands in a diagram, so basically this is our mouth, this is our lower lip, chin and here. Tongue is present, so almost here ears are present. This is our parotid gland. It is present near the ears, parotid gland, and the opening is towards the upper portion, the upper jaw. Now, this is tongue. So, I said sublingual gland is present below the tongue. So, these are the ducts, openings of our sublingual gland, and this is here sublingual gland is present and this is the duct. The submandibular, that is also present on the lower side, lower near the lower jaw, but at a specific angle, and this will be our submaxillary. This will be sublingual and this is submaxillary, or you can say submandibular gland. So this is how the three salivary glands are present. Now, function of all the three salivary glands are to release saliva. What saliva is basically containing? This saliva is containing only one single digestive enzyme, that is known as salivary amylase. And this salivary amylase is responsible for the digestion of carbohydrates only. Other than this, this is containing some of the electrolytes like sodium ion are there, chloride ion are there, bicarbonate ions are also present. Other than this, lysozyme is present, that is antimicrobial in nature, means it is responsible for the killing of any microorganism that is present in the food. Ions of thiocyanate are also present in saliva, that is also responsible for killing of some of the microorganisms like bacteria. Now the pH of this complete saliva is slightly acidic, that is near about 6.8 pH is there. And this saliva, when we are going to engulf our food, this saliva is going to mix with our food, and it leads to digestion of some of the components of our food. Now the second gland that is present is gastric glands, and these gastric glands are present in our stomach. The function of these gastric glands is to secrete a juice, and that juice is known as gastric juice. Simply, the secretion of gastric glands are known as gastric juice. If you remember, earlier we talked about the histology of alimentary canal, and in that histology I talked about that interiorly lumen is present, and this lumen is surrounded by epithelium, and this epithelium is involved in formation of most of the glands of our digestive system. So in stomach, these gastric glands are basically formed by the extension of this epithelium. How this epithelium is going to extend? Suppose this is the epithelium, it is going to move inwards like this way, and it is containing several cells which are involved in secretion. First, let's talk about the different type of cells that are present in our gastric glands. The first cells are chief cells. These chief cells, here our epithelium is present. This is how cells are present, and these cells are known as chief cells. What are the function of these chief cells? These chief cells are involved in the secretion of proenzymes. In earlier classes also we have discussed that proenzymes are the inactive enzymes, and in stomach basically two inactive enzymes are secreted, pepsinogen and prorenin. Both of these enzymes are involved in the digestion of proteins. Other than these two enzymes, some other enzymes are also being secreted like gastric amylase, almost non-functional because of the pH of stomach, and gastric lipase, that is involved in the digestion of fats. So this is the function of chief cells. Now some of the elongated cells are present over here. These are known as oxyntic cells. So this is a oxyntic cell. These oxyntic cells are involved in the secretion of HCl, hydrochloric acid, that is going to maintain acidic pH in the stomach. And another is Castle intrinsic gastric factor. We discussed earlier also that is helpful in the absorption of vitamin B12. So this is the function of oxyntic cells. Now some mucus cells. This is how mucus cells are present. This is a mucus cell, and as the name suggests, these mucus cells are responsible for the secretion of mucus. The function of mucus is to protect our stomach walls from the action of HCl. Now, this gastric gland, these are the exocrine parts of a gastric gland. Means these parts are going to release enzymes, and it is also containing some endocrine parts on its lower side, like argentafin cells are present, and G cells are present. We can say gastrin cells are present. These are endocrine part because these are involved in the secretion of some hormones. Like this gland is responsible for the secretion of serotonin, somatostatin, histamine. So these are different hormones. What this serotonin is doing? This serotonin is basically responsible for vasoconstriction. Constriction of muscles, and it is leading to activation of smooth muscles. Somatostatin, it is acting as an inhibitor and it inhibits the secretion of gastric juice. Histamine, it is also responsible for the dilation of blood vessels. These G cells are going to release a hormone named gastrin, and this gastrin is stimulating the gastric glands to release gastric juice. So these are some of the hormones that are being secreted in stomach. Now let's talk about the pH. pH is highly important because each and every enzyme functions at a specific pH. If pH will be changed, the activity of enzyme will also be affected. So pH is almost 1.5 to 2. That means highly acidic pH. So stomach is highly acidic pH. These are the two important glands. If you talk about their secretion, so near about 1000 to 1500 ml of salivary glands are secreting saliva per day, and near about 2000 to 3000 ml of gastric juice is secreted in stomach per day. So next time we will discuss about the third important gland, that is liver, in detail.